Let's take a look now at the idea of calculating some confidence intervals for a correlation coefficient. Now, the calculate the confidence interval for rho, regardless of whether it's rho sub S, Spearman's, or simply rho, Pearson's, we actually use the exact same process. Now, the way I'm going to go about this here is I'm going to go straight to the calculator and use a program designed to do it. In your book, it shows you how to actually calculate by hand if you're interested in actually doing it by hand. So let's just suppose that our sample correlation is 0.9429 and n equals 6. So let's go ahead and do a 95% confidence interval. So in the calculator, go to Program, and we're going to look for rho CI. There it is. Rho CI, confidence interval for rho. Select it, run it. R.9429, enter. Sample size of 6. Now it asks for alpha. Well, if I want 95% confidence interval, alpha must be 0.05. Hit enter, and there it is. Lower is 0.5594, and the upper is 0.9939. Now that's a pretty big range. Let me write this down somewhere real quickly here. So what do we have? For n equals 6, we had 0.55, I forgot what it was already, 94, all the way to 0.99, what was it? 39. Clearly bounded from 0, so it looks like there's a positive association, but this is saying anywhere from weak, 0.5. If you actually look at data with a correlation of 0.5, it looks more like a cloud to me than anything else, all the way to 0.99, which is incredibly strong. Now, suppose that we had a larger sample size. Suppose n equals 20. We had a sample size of 20 that we end up with the same sample correlation. Let's run the program again. N was 20, and work with the same alpha, 0.05. This is a 95% confidence interval. Now it's 0.85 to 0.975. So 0.8587. All the way to 9575. See, the interval now is getting much, much tighter. Much tighter. 0.85 is pretty strong. 0.95 is really strong. So I think you can see from that, like anything else, if you increase the sample size, the larger the sample size, the better the estimate. And it's the same idea that we saw when we're doing confidence interval for the mean or for the proportion, anything else. The larger the sample size, the holding everything else constant, the smaller the interval is going to be, the better the estimate is going to be. Now, keep in mind, like I said, this is for R. This could have easily been for R sub S. It doesn't make any difference. The way we go about calculating the confidence interval is exactly the same whether you're dealing with Pearson's or Spearman's. And in both these, the interpretation is the same. You're 95% certain that the true correlation, whatever it is somewhere between 0.55 and 0.99, or if we had this larger sample size, in between roughly 0.85 and 0.95. That's it. That's all there is to calculating a confidence interval for rho.